Pennsylvania.
Romania, Europe's enduro mecca, and a great chance to ride the same tracks as those used in Romaniacs. But I actually want to talk about China in this video and whether Chinese motorbikes and products are a good thing or not. 2 years ago, I reported on the first two-stroke enduro bike from China with the engine based on an old Yamaha design and bits and pieces borrowed from other brands. And then I followed up with a review of a Chinese 450, which copied Honda's old CRF 450X design. I asked if this was a good thing. Could China finally lift its quality control, produce reliable bikes, and give us good budget dirt bikes? Unfortunately, it turns out the Chinese factory producing the 450 never purchased the rights to copy Honda's design, despite telling hopeful importers otherwise. I became a bit more disillusioned when I began to investigate boots recently. So many brands that were previously known for good quality had dropped in recent years, and the common theme seemed to be they were no longer made in their country of origin. Moose boots, made in China. Ditto for O'Neill. Fly, Thor, and Fox boots. And speaking of Fox, it turns out the vast majority of their gear is now made in China. And the general consensus among long-term riders is that this formerly passionate US-based brand has been on a long, slow decline in quality as they rely more and more on Chinese-made products. Now, of course, some Chinese-made products can be good quality if Western standards of quality control are introduced and rigorously enforced. We certainly hope this is the case, as KTM is now having some of their bikes made in China, and I'm sure other manufacturers will slowly follow suit. But here is my question: even if the quality is good, is this a good thing? Since the Tiananmen Square massacre, China has become more authoritarian instead of becoming more democratic. China has just killed a number of Indian soldiers along their border. They are claiming the South China Sea as their own and building illegal bases. Up to a million of the Uyghur minority group are confined to re-education camps within China. And China has been throwing its economic might around into punishing countries, such as Australia recently. Cyber attacks are either sponsored by the Chinese government or at the very least allowed to occur. You have to admit it's not a great track record for a country that is emerging now as a major world power. But what do you guys think? Does it really matter where our motorbike products are made? Overall, is it a good thing that so much of our stuff is made in China now because we pay less? I'm keen to hear your opinions, and look, if it does matter, I might put some work in discovering more about where all our riding gear is made. Let me know what you think in the comments. But guys, please, no outright racist comments. I have to delete those. And remember, if you like the look of that Romaniac's riding, check out Carpathian Adventures.